my dear students, welcome back to my English literature class of class 4. So children, today I am back here with chapter number 4 of our English Mulberry book, and the name of our chapter is The Hero of Harlem. The children, it's part 3. In the previous parts of this chapter, I had explained you the story and few exercises, right? And now in this video, that is part 3, I'm going to discuss the question answers of this chapter. Okay, so let's learn. So children, here is the reference to context, and in this an extract has been taken from the story, and based on that extract, few questions are being asked which we have to answer, right? So let's see the extract. Yes, while the wind turned the windmills and the rain watered the tulips, the strained and swollen dikes kept filling. So children, if you remember, when Hans had a long walk to Mr. Jameson's house, no? Because Mr. Jameson used to live at the edge of the town, which was close to the dikes, isn't it? That's why he had a long walk, no? Yeah. So when he was going, so that day, the spring rain was much heavier than usual, no? Yes, it was pouring down hard each day and night, isn't it? Yes. So that time, while the wind turned the windmills, because, you know, the piercing wind was there, isn't it? Yes, the wind was also very hard, very fast, isn't it? Yes. So the windmills were turned and the rain watered the tulips. Yes, the strained and swollen dikes kept filling, means the dikes were getting filled with water, isn't it? Yes, they were getting filled with water, and that's why they were swollen. Yes, so this is an extract. Now let's see the questions which are being asked here. So here is question A. Apart from the dikes, which two other things mentioned in these lines tell us where the story is set? So children, just look at these lines and find out. Yes, which two other things are mentioned here other than dikes? Yes, windmills and tulips. Yes, so let's see the answer. Windmills and tulips are also mentioned in these lines that tell us where the story is set. Now let's see the next question. Question B. What does the author mean by saying the dikes were swollen? So children, the dikes were swollen. What do you mean by swollen? Yes, it means like something is enlarged, or we can say extended, isn't it? Children, have you ever got an insect bite? Yes, of course you would have got, no? Yeah, so have you observed when an insect bites, no? Then that particular part of our body is it becomes red, no? Yeah, and we say now that this particular part is swelling, it's swelling, swelling is there, isn't it? Yes, why? Because insect infills some type of fluid into our body, and because of that, that particular body part is swollen. So same way here with the dikes, and author has used the word swollen for the dikes here. So what does it mean? Yes, the dikes were filling with water, no? Yeah, so after filling with water, the dikes were swollen. Yes, so let's see the answer. The author means that the dikes were getting filled with water. Yes, now let's see the next question, that is question C. What did Hans wonder when he saw the dikes? So children, when he saw the dikes, as he was knowing that his father was out of the city, no? Yeah, who used to take care of the dikes, who used to repair the dikes, isn't it? Yes, so he was worried that as father is not here and the dikes are getting filled with water, so if something happens wrong, something goes wrong, then who will take care, who will repair, isn't it? Yeah, that's why he wondered. So let's see the answer. Hans wondered that who would repair the dikes if something goes wrong. Isn't it? Yes. So children, here is another extract. Let's see. My lad, said Mr. Jensen, first I will take you home and then I will tell everyone of the boy who saved the town. So children, here, these lines Mr. Jensen is saying to Hans. Yes. As if you remember, he saved the town, the whole town he saved. How he saved? He plugged the hole with his hand. Isn't it? Yeah, though the rain kept pelting and the wind continued to swirl. But still, Hans kept his fist plugged in the hole, isn't it? Yeah, he did not stop. Yeah, and he saved the town. Yes, so now let's see the questions which are being asked. Question A. Where was Mr. Jensen when he said these lines? So children, where was he? You remember? Yes, Mr. Jensen was standing near Hans, no? Then only he said all this, no? Yes, when Hans was calling for help, when Mr. Jensen came out simply with his dog, he saw all that and then he called the people who repaired the dike, isn't it? So when then he said these lines to Hans. So he was standing near Hans and the dike which had a hole, isn't it? Yes. So let's see the answer. Mr. Jensen was standing near Hans and the dike which had a hole. Yes. Now let's see the next question. That is question B. Who did Mr. Jensen call my lad? Why did he want to get him home? So children, who did Mr. Jensen call? My lad. Yes, he called my lad to Hans. Yes, Hans. And why he wanted him to get home? He said, no, that first I will take you home and then I'll tell everyone of the boy who saved the town. Yes, so why do you think that he wanted Hans to get home first, to go home back? Yes, because Hans was standing over there. He was standing in the rain, in a heavy rain for a long time. Yeah, it was cold, isn't it? Yes, he may fall sick. That's why. Yeah, so let's see the answer. Mr. Jensen called Hans my lad. He wanted to get him home because Hans was out in the cold for a long time. Yes. Now let's see the next question. This line shows that Mr. Jensen was. So children, what this line shows? Yes, that as Mr. Jensen said, no, that I will tell everyone of the boy who saved the town, means the hero of the town, isn't it? Yes, this shows that Mr. Jensen was proud of the boy, isn't it? Yes, so this line shows that Mr. Jensen was proud of the boy. Yes. Now one more question is there. So let's see that question. Question D. What do you think Mr. Jensen told the people of Harlem? So children, what do you think? What Mr. Jensen would have told the people? Yes, he said no, that he will tell about the boy who saved the town. Yes, so he would have told, no, that how this young boy has saved the entire city. Isn't it? Yeah, that of bravery. Yes. So let's see the answer. Mr. Jensen would have told the people of Harlem how Hans saved the entire city. Yes. Right? So these are the reference to context. Now we'll have the direct questions. Okay. Read, reflect and write. So children, now read, reflect and write. So now here are the direct questions. Okay. So let's see the question. Yes, question number 5 listed here in our book. List the words and phrases from the story that describe the weather. So children, so many words and phrases are being used in the story to describe the weather. Like if you remember, the cold rain, the rain kept pelting, or piercing cold wind, isn't it? Hard rain, spring rain, wind continued swirling, all these words and phrases were used in the story, isn't it? That were describing the weather. So let's see the answer. So we have listed here. Rainy, spring rain, hard rain, piercing cold wind, cold rain, rain kept pelting, and wind continued to swirl are the words and phrases from the story that describe the weather. Yes. Now let's see. Next question. Question number 6. Why do you think Mr. Jensen was always very happy when Hans came to visit? So children, what do you think that why he was always happy to see Hans? Yes. Yes, because you know, old people, no, they always love to tell about the stories of their past and all, isn't it? Yeah, and they want someone to hear their stories and enjoy. Yeah, so when Hans used to visit Mr. Jensen, no, so he used to tell him the stories, and Hans also used to listen very nicely, no? Yeah, so that's why he enjoyed the company of Hans. And this is the reason he was always happy when Hans visited, isn't it? Yeah, so let's see the answer. Mr. Jensen enjoyed telling Hans stories about how things were long ago. Okay, yes, so now let's see the next question, that is question number 7. Do you think The Hero of Harlem is a good title for this story? Give a reason to support your answer. Suggest another suitable title for the story. So children, what do you think? The Hero of Harlem, is it a good title for the story or not? Yes, of course. I think yes. Because he was the hero, no? Hans showed his heroism, isn't it? Yes, and he saved the town. Yeah, the city of Harlem. So The Hero of Harlem is a very appropriate title, no? For the story, yes. So just suggest another title. Yes, many other suitable titles can be there for the story, no children? Like Hans Saves the Day, this also we can put. Or Hans the Savior of the Town, or Savior of Harlem, because he saved the city of Harlem, isn't it? Yes. So let's see the answer. One title I have suggested here, which is suitable for the story. Yes, I think it is a good title because the story talks of a young hero who saved the city of Harlem. Yes. And another title is Hans the Savior of Harlem. Yes. So now here is question number 8, children. List two qualities of Hans that you admire. How do Hans' actions in the story show us that he has these qualities? So children, what do you think? The two qualities. Yes, that he was a kind boy, isn't it? Yes, he was a kind boy and was a brave boy as well, no? So how do you think this? He was kind, but that's why only he went to Mr. Jensen just to deliver food, no? Though he used to live at the edge of the town, which was far away from his house, isn't it? Yes. And about his bravery, he is a brave boy as he stopped the water seeping in and saved the town. Yes, this was the act of bravery. Yes, so let's see the answer. Two qualities of Hans that we admire are kindness and bravery. In the story, we see that Hans is a kind boy as he walked way out to the edge of the town just to deliver food to Mr. Jensen. Isn't it? Yes. And second, also he is brave as he stopped the water seeping in and saved the town. So children, these are the question answers which you have to learn and write very neatly in your copy. Okay? So children, here is the exercise word wall. Let's see. Mr. Jensen loved telling stories. Yes. Stories can be classified into different genres and categories. A genre is a style or category of art, music or literature. Yes. So children, here is an exercise that describes different types of stories. So you have to choose the correct genre from the box to complete the flowchart. Okay. And one has been done for you. You can see. Like a story, a short story that has been passed down from generation to generation. Yeah. It is a folk tale. Yes. It is given. Now let's see next one. A short moral story, usually with animals as characters. Yes, that is fable. Yeah, fable. Now next one. A story about magical people, places and animals. Yes, fairy tales. Magical people, places and animals. Fairy tale. Yes. Let's see next. A story in which exciting, even dangerous things happen to the characters. Yeah, that is an adventure, isn't it? Yes, that's adventure. Next one, a story of a real person's life written by the person. A story of a real person's life written by the person himself. Yeah, that is autobiography. Yes, autobiography. Now let's see next one. A story that uses descriptions of science and technology. Often set in the future, it may include robots, aliens and time machines. Yes, children, that is science fiction. Yes. Now the last one, a suspense filled story. Wow, a suspense filled story about a puzzling event that is not solved until the end of the story. Yes, that is a mystery, isn't it? Yes. So this exercise you have to do in your book very neatly. So now children, next question of the word ball is, find words from the story that are the antonyms of the following words. So children, here few words are given and you have to write down the antonyms of these given words which are being used in the story. Okay, yeah. So first one is unkind. So the antonym of unkind will be, yes, kind. Now young, yes, old. For rarely, the word which is opposite to this and which has been used in the story, yes, frequently. Now the next word is saddened. The opposite is, yes, cheer up. Now no one, yes, everyone. destroyed? Yes, built. Okay. Now children, it's the time for your home assignment. I hope you all have enjoyed the video. Yes. So in your homework, what you have to do? You have to learn and write all the question answers in your mulberry copy and all the exercises in your book very neatly. Okay children? Yes. And don't forget to read the story again. Yes. Okay then children, take care. Bye bye.